Hey, before I start the video, guys, I just want to say a huge shout out to my notification gang. You guys have really been coming in clutch lately. Like, I've really been noticing a lot more new people that have been showing up to my videos early and commenting. So make sure you guys continue up that good work, because I will make sure to heart your comments if you guys comment early. And also, guys, I'm going to be playing this game, Criminality, once more again on my channel. You know, this is my first time experimenting with games like outside the anime community, you know what I'm saying? So make sure you guys leave in the comments section down below, you know, if you guys actually do enjoy this content, because, you know, my last video on this game did pretty well, but I want to know if I could continuously upload this game, because, like, I'm really enjoying it. I'm a huge fan of this game. If you guys haven't got this game already, I would 100% recommend, I would 120% recommend you guys to get this game, because I have literally been playing this game every single day. Like, it's to the point where, like, fans actually notice me in the game, because, like, I've been just playing this game, like, I'm in so many servers. You guys should go ahead and get this game, because high chance you're probably gonna see me in game, guys. High, very high chance. So make sure you guys go ahead in the description down below. You guys don't have to look anywhere. Go to my description, join the Discord, go buy that game. Make sure you guys, you know, join me in the game. So let me teach you guys how to actually play this game called Criminality. Are you guys lonely in the streets? Do you guys have no gang and keep getting jumped by big gangs? Well, you guys came to the right place if that is so. I'm going to be teaching you guys how to get started in this game called Criminality. I understand that it can be very unforgiving, but I'm going to be teaching you guys how to get, you know, lots of cash, some spots around the map that you guys can go to, you know, pretty much how to get started. So let's actually get started. Alright guys, so let's start off this beginner's guide. Right here, we got your bank, we got cash, allowance, and bounty. Alright, so pretty much every time you grip somebody, your bounty goes up. Every 10 minutes, you get an allowance, and you guys can boost your allowance by joining the group, which is in the game description. So once you guys go into the game description will have the group that you can join to get, I'm pretty sure, 20% increase in your allowance every 10 minutes, or you can go right over here to the store and get yourself this game pass, which will allow you to get 50% extra income, which I have got, guys. So make sure you guys go ahead and get that game pass if you guys are enjoying this game. And yeah, that's pretty much for your allowance. Your cash is how you buy items, actually, and your bank is, you know, your safe money, your safekeeping. You guys can die and you guys will not lose any of your bank money. So what is the difference between having your money in cash and having your money in bank, you guys may ask? Let's go ahead to the black to a normal dealer and let's talk to him so I can explain, you know, how it works. So we're gonna go over to him. And while we're here, let's explain how, you know, the dealer system works. All right. So when you talk to him, there's a restock every so often. So right now the restock's in 15 seconds and you get a protection status in game while you are not in combat. So if you're in combat, you will not get this protection status. But if you're in, like, if you are in combat, you will not get this. But if you're not in combat, you will get this. So right now I got that little force field while I'm talking to the dude. These have been restocked. So every 20 minutes. So while you're here, you could pretty much buy anything right here with cash. So let's say I wanted to get this. I have 100 cash. I'll buy it, purchase. I don't have enough cash, but I have enough in the bank. So pretty much how this works is you can only use bank cash to pretty much unlock stuff. So let's say I want this C4. I'm about to unlock it because obviously. So now I can purchase this with cash. So to actually purchase the items, you need to have cash on you. And there's various ATMs located around the map. So right here, we're gonna claim our allowance real quick. This is just part of the video. We're just gonna claim it. As you guys can see, it just goes straight to the bank. So there's various ATMs around the map with different looks. So this is one of the ATM looks, and there's a different ATM. So they're in the walls like this. You can withdraw or deposit. Same thing, you guys have the active protection while you guys are not in combat. All right, so that's pretty much it for, like, the just the basic starters and whatnot. Let's move on to, like, looting. You know what I'm saying? That's another ATM. What the other ATM looks like. Let's pretty much move on to, you know, looting and whatnot. Alright guys, so looting is a big part of this game, especially if you guys are beginners. This is just for beginners, because once you guys get to higher levels, you guys get your weapons, you guys can kill people, and you guys can pretty much get your income off of killing people. But let's say you guys are noobs, you guys want to be a little bit more passive. I'm gonna be showing you guys a nice trinket pathing, you know what I'm saying? Like, not trinket pathing, money path, where you guys can pretty much just grab a lot of money. Sorry, I used like rogue lineage terms because I'm used to like rogue, but it's kind of like a trinket pass. So what you pretty much want to do, start off at this motel, go right up here, This is what I usually do when I used to play. You go right up here. You can grab these saves. I'm not going to grab them because there's two dudes in here. You guys can go ahead and grab those safes. So you can just hold F, open them both. After you guys open those both up, you guys will get some pretty good cash. You want to go right over here. So run right over here, right here. And you're going to get another safe that should be... Yeah, should be right at the end right there. You can go ahead and open this. There's no people here. I just didn't want to, you know, ruin, like, the path. They would just attack me, and you know what I'm saying. So we'll go ahead and open this one. As you guys can see, not too bad on cash. It's just a green box. It's not like a red one. The red ones have, like, so much cash. I'm pretty sure the red ones, they give you, like, 500 cash. But this is where we get to the good part. You're going to want to head all the way up to the tower real quick. So let's head up to the tower. And then I'll talk when we get there. All right, guys, now that we made it upstairs, we are now on the roof. You're just going to want to run to this room right over here, because that camera right over here, that will shoot at you. Right now, it's looking at me. It's waiting to shoot at me as soon as I move. But yeah, it should pretty much have both safes closed. You guys can open these safes. Somebody already took them. But what I'm going to do right here is get the scrap. Make sure you guys do not miss out on the scrap. You guys can get some pretty good money or weapons, especially if they're red. They have a high chance of, you know, dropping weapons and money. That's an easy $100. Usually, these safes right here, these are the main thing that you guys are gonna wanna go for. These big safes, like, bro, I'm telling you, these store cash in them. Like, you would probably get, I would say, the least you're going to get from coming up here is around, like, 500 if you guys get both of them. But anyways, let's go back down and talk about more stuff to do with this game. You know what I'm saying? This is like the full beginner's guide to get you guys started. All right, guys, let's talk about getting weapons and stuff. This is all personal opinion for beginners and whatnot, so you guys do not have to listen to what I'm saying in this portion of the video, but I'm just going to be giving you guys weapon preferences on beginner weapons. So let's say you're a beginner, you don't have any game passes, you're a fresh start, you know, you just watch my video. You know, you're farming some cash, but you're still low on cash. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to waste all your money. What I would definitely recommend you guys get is either the Shiv or the Bayonet, guys. These are, like, some of the fastest attacking melee weapons, and they just give the bleed effect. You guys really don't need any weapons to start off with. I mean, you could try and unlock this. This is pretty good as well, but I just never used it. But what I could recommend, if you guys do have extra Robux, guys, I would recommend going to the store right here, getting this Armory Game Pass. You say 450 Robux, bro, I'm not about to spend that. But let me tell you what you guys get with that Armory Game Pass. I'm going to go over to the Armory myself right here, and I'm going to show you guys what you get. What you get is pretty good. You guys get some of the most powerful weapons in the game. It's not pay to win though, guys. Do not be like, oh y'all, this is so pay to win. No, it's not, bro. It's like, shut up. Listen here, you can get just as good as weapons from the black market dealer. Like, he sells, like, Tommy guns, you know what I'm saying? So this dude, he sells the M4A1, the UMP, the Magnum, the MP7, Super Shorty. Of course, these are a lot easier to get. That's what you're paying for. You're paying for the ease of access, not the pay to win part, you know. Like, oh, he can have a better weapon than me that I can't get. Sure, he can get an M4 and you can't, but you have access to weapons that are just as powerful. Let me show you what I'm talking about. But, oh, actually, yeah. So, right here, what was I saying? Okay, back on track. The Armory has a lot better weapons that you can get earlier on. So you can get the machete, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot better. Like, the machete is just the prime example. The machete is so good, guys. I still use the machete till today. I've been using it since day one. It's only $600. And especially with this game pass I got right here as well, this extra income game pass, I can pretty much buy one every 10 minutes. I'll have enough money to fuel, machete every 10 minutes. So right here, we'll go to guns, and you guys, like I'm saying, you guys can afford the AK, the Tommy gun, the Deagle, the M1. You know, this is pretty much what the Armory doesn't have, and they're pretty much on the same level, same tier. You just have to unlock it on your own. The only thing that you're paying for with the Armory is ease of access. And do I recommend that game pass? I would give it an 8 out of 10. So it's a pretty good buy. Make sure you guys get that if you guys, you know, play this game. So, you know what I'm saying? But that's pretty much just my preferences on buying weapons and stuff, and that should conclude the pretty much tutorial or guide or whatever. So yeah. Thank you guys so much for making it to the end of the video. I hope you guys did learn something from this video about criminality. I hope it brought you to the game. And if it did, you know, if you guys see me in game, I would love for you guys to come over and say hello to me. But that is only if I'm walking around. If I'm in the middle of a gunfight and you guys are running up to me and being like, "Hi, Sprays," obviously, high chances are you're going to get shot because I don't know who's my opponent is, whose team is on who. Gangs are so big nowadays where like any random stranger walking up to you can be a part of like a gang, like randoms just be joining in. So if I'm walking around, if I'm chilling with, you know, some friends or whatever, you walk up to me and you say, "Hey, Sprays, what's up?" You know, obviously I'll be friendly with you. So don't, you guys don't have to worry about seeing me in game and me being toxic, unless, you know, sometimes everybody's toxic once in a while. But nonetheless, thank you guys so much for watching till the end. You guys know how much I appreciate that. Please make sure you guys leave in a comment if you guys did make it to the end of the video. Just put black shades at the end of your comment. So if you guys are leaving a normal comment, just put black shades. So be like, "Hi, Sprays, nice video, black shades." That's like the code message, so I know you guys made it to the end. And I will definitely give you guys, your guys' comment, a like and a heart. So thank you guys, and I'll hopefully I will be seeing you guys in the next video. Peace out.